Good evening, Laila Tov.
Boa noite.
It's a great honor and joy to welcome you all in our Shaaré Tikvá synagogue for this ceremony as part of the program of such important international conference which has been held in Portugal. Starting the ceremony, we'd like to invite the director of the DAHAN Center, Dr. Shimon Oyon, for his message.
Thank you.
thank you and good evening. Mrs. Anna Godinho, Secretary of State, Portugal, our ambassador from the State of Israel to Portugal, Mr. Rafael, Gamzu, the rabbi of the Jewish community in Lisbon, Rabbi Nathan Perez, all the members of the academic committee who organized this conference, and I'll start with the co-chairs, Professor Moshe Orfali, Professor Jose Alberto Tabin, Professor Dov Stushinsky, Professor Shimon Sharvit, Professor Moshe Amar, Professor Elvira Mea, and the last, of course, from the Ben Zvi Institute, Dr. Yoel Mal. It is a great pleasure and honor to open this festive dinner that was organized together with the Jewish community of Lisbon, the DAHAN Center in Bar-Ilan University, and the Israeli Embassy to Portugal. This is really an historic moment to attend this special ceremony at this synagogue, Shaaré, Tikvá, which symbolized the renewal of the Jewish community in Lisbon and Portugal as a whole. After the tragedy of the expulsion from Spain and Portugal for hundreds of years, that people also, Jewish people, in a matter of fact, were absent. Therefore, I would like from here also to call our host, our partner for this, not only for this evening, for the conference, because the first person I met with in Israel to talk about the conference and to organize also the reception was the president of the Jewish community in Lisbon, Mr. Gabriel Steinhardt. Therefore, I'm calling you also to present your speech.
Good evening. Your Excellency, Mrs. Anna-Mensch Godinho, Secretary of State of Tourism. Your Excellency, Mr. Rafael Gamzu, Ambassador of Israel in Portugal. My dear peer, Mr. João Diogo, Vice President of the Jewish Community at Belmonte. Mr. Shimon Ofayun, Director of the Bar-Ilan University's DAHAN Center. Dr. Pinhas, Haliwa, Director of the Ashkelon Academic College. Distinguished professors and respected scholars from so many countries around the world, some of you I'm honored to know personally, but please forgive me for not naming you all. Dear members of the Jewish community of Lisbon, ladies and gentlemen, dear guests and friends, it is a moment of great privilege and honor for me, on behalf of the Jewish community of Lisbon, to extend a hearty welcome to all of you today to our Shaaré Tikvá Synagogue, which literally means gates of hope. I'm going to give you my phone if you don't mind.
Yes.
Sorry, you still want me to answer?
Please do not forget to turn off your phone. As I did myself, so I'm such a bad example. Thank you and my apologies. So I was saying, it's a moment of a great privilege and honor for me on behalf of the Jewish community of Lisbon to extend a hearty welcome to all of you today to our Shaaré Tikvá Synagogue, which literally means in Hebrew, Gates of Hope. Going back in time, some say that the Jewish community of Lisbon is one of the oldest in Europe. It could probably go back 1,000 years, and the first Jews may have arrived to Lisbon as merchants in the galleys of their Phoenician neighbors, or at least as slaves of the Romans, who destroyed the Temple of Jerusalem in the year of 70 of the Christian era, initiating the diaspora of the Jewish people. Now, regardless of these assumptions, what we know for sure is that in 1147, when Dom Afonso VIII, King of Portugal, the first one, conquered Lisbon from the Moors, the city already had a Jewish population concentrated in a neighborhood located in the slopes of São Jorge Castle, which descends down to the River Tagus. In the reign of Dom Dinis, in the transition from the 13th to the 14th century, Lisbon already had a Jewish population estimated at around 1,500 souls, which, by the way, accounted for 8% of the total population of the city. However, sadly, as you all know, the Jewish presence in the city suffered an abrupt interruption in 1497, following the pseudo decree of expulsion and maybe the forced conversion of all Jews of the kingdom. It was only the first decade of the 19th century that some sporadic invitations were made to members of the Jewish communities of Portuguese origin to return to the homeland of their ancestors. The first to reside in Lisbon were the Moroccan Jews. Some came directly and others after spending some time in Gibraltar or in Brazil. Morocco was then going through a period of great instability and governmental changes. As usual, Jews were blamed for all sorts of misfortunes. Some had to live hidden for long periods and opted to flee to Gibraltar, to Portugal, and to some other countries. Since formally speaking, the Inquisition still existed in Portugal, the first group settled in the Algarve created an active, strong, and important community in the city of Faro. The first to come up to Lisbon were those from Gibraltar, who felt relatively safe as they were British subjects. Now, this synagogue, built in 1904, with funds gathered by what was then referred as the Israelite colony of Lisbon, was the first Portuguese synagogue built in Portugal since 1496. The monarch was then Dom Manuel II, and no non-Christian temple such as ours was allowed to have a street for sale. That is why the reason we do not have a for sale towards the street. The Jewish community itself was only officially recognized by the already Republican government in 1912. Ashkenazi families, such as mine, came later, in between the world wars, due to the economy deterioration in the countries where they lived. They sought to reach the Americas, but they did not have the means to cover the cost of the tickets, so finally they stayed. Lisbon was a convenient stopover, and it must be said that the already established Sephardic community was supportive, very supportive, and showed solidarity towards these Jewish immigrants. Many of them ended up staying in Portugal, making important contributions to the community and to the country's economy. In the 1940s, during and following the Second World War, the community experienced a period of frantic activity. Tens of thousands of Jewish refugees from Central Europe passed through Lisbon on the run. Aristides de Sousa Mendes, the Consul General of Portugal at Bordeaux, just among the nations, may he rest in peace, granted them a very large number of entry visas. Working first with the American Tri-Distribution Committee, and then independently, the Jewish community of Lisbon assured all kinds of support to the refugees, even for those confined to residence in towns like outside the capital, such Ericeira, etc. It was a time when the existing synagogues were insufficient, mind you, to contain the large number of believers, especially in the great festivities, and ballrooms had to be rented to accommodate everyone to religious services. Lisbon was, for those Jews, a port of hope. However, some years after World War II, the refugees had already left, and our community was therefore reduced to its natural site. Nowadays, Lisbon, as among other European capitals, one of the smallest represent a tiny percentage of the capital's total population. 500 to 1,000 is a hypothetical census. Since there are many registered members, who are heads of households, others who are not paying members, and many others who are not even registered. Gladly, in recent years, there is a tendency for growth, mainly due to the immigration of Brazilian, French, and Turkish Jews. But the absolute numbers are still insignificant if we take into consideration this, that in 1497, Jews accounted for one-fifth of the total Portuguese population. Nevertheless, the community does its best to ensure its members the vast majority of services, as other Jewish communities all over Europe, with the exception of a Jewish school. Excellencies, distinguished audience, ladies and gentlemen, the DAHAN Center has insisted with us to host your party, which was originally supposed to be of some 50 to 80 people, and grew into over 200, together with the members of our community, of course. Therefore, you may find the space outside, once we let you go outside, which is not right now, a bit tiny, and we beg in advance for your understanding for some discomfort. Let me assure you that we are indeed delighted to have you here in this joint initiative with the Center and the Embassy of Israel, as we are very grateful to both for their partial sponsoring. We hope that with the most significant growth of Jewish tourists coming to visit the city of Lisbon, we shall be able to work with our city mayor to find a solution for a large community center. Can you hear this noise? No, it's not only me, okay. So I'll go again. We do hope that with the growth, most significant growth of the Jewish tourists coming to visit the city of Lisbon, we shall be able soon to work out with our city mayor a solution for a large community center in town. Amen. A team of staff and volunteers led mainly by Vice President Liam Ram, our executive, our executive director, Marcus Priest, and our event manager, Gabriel Levy, worked hard and for many hours to make sure that this event will be a success. Chef Rafael prepared the delicious food under the kashrut supervision of our rabbi and our master, Nathan Perez, and the supervision of Mr. David Nunes Naval, a Dutch subject, but nevertheless, by far, more Portuguese than myself. Our gratitude to all of them. And now for the ending note, my dear friends. For us Jews, the synagogue, Beit Knesset in Hebrew, is not only a place of worship as a church, but also a place of reunion. It is an honor and an immense pleasure to gather and welcome here such a large group of both Jews and non-Jews. We wish you a fruitful conference at the universities of Lisbon and Porto. Shalom, bruchim abayim lebeit haknesset Shaaré Tikvá shel Kahal Kadosh Lisbon. Shalom e sejam bem-vindos à Sinagoga Shaaré Tikvá da Santa Congregação de Lisboa. Bem-ar, thank you all.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gabriel Steinhardt. If I would know about your speech, I would include it also in the conference, because really we could study a lot, don't we, Professor Tabin, about the Portugal Jewish community. You still have a chance to come and to enrich us tomorrow, and maybe in Porto. Thank you very much. I asked also to introduce two important people from Israel that are with us. The first one is the poet Erez Biton. Erez Biton won Israel Prize for Poetry just 2-3 years ago. And really we are proud that he is with us because really he's involved in Israel in different conventions, seminars, in which he is trying also to speak about this Sephardic heritage. And of course that his poetry is influenced by the history and this culture that came from Spain and Portugal. Erez Biton will read, introduce to us a few poems that will be also translated by our traditional translator, Barda, that will be with us now. I'm calling upon Erez Biton, Bevakasha.
מתחת לשקט הזה הציב קצוצי ענף עדות שקר לשקט באר עמוקה בפציו שקר של שקט זיתים עתיקים ברחש ים הכל שקר כי מתחת למסווה לשקט הזה יש שקט אחר שקט שהוא פחד פחד המקים במנעולים, פחד הבתים העלולים להיות פעורים עם קירות נפולים. כי מתחת לשקט הזה אדמה מבעפעת באותיות עבריות. ספרים גנוזים מוחבאים מתחת לעצים דורות על דורות. כי מתחת לשקט הזה צעקות גדולות בקולות גילים. ומתחת לשקט הזה, זמן שהוא אשליה מפוררת, פסוקים חקוקים בתקרות עזובות של בתי כנסת נטושים. כי מתחת לשקט הזה, בשר מתלעלע במכשירי עינויים ומסמרים חדים. כי מתחת לשקט הזה, ספרי תורה תוססים מאות בשנים בתוך מנעולים במרתפים סגורים. שם, במרתפים הנעודים. לדבר על עיר בפניה. יהודי הנעזבים מעיר, שרחובותיה מורדות מורדות, דוחקים ברגליהם לצאת. יהודי הנעזבים מעיר, אשר חתמה את שמה בגבם, כמו אות מהבהב בעולם, טולדו. למגורשים העובדים בים. איך לאסוף את הצעקה האילמת מן הים כשסירות הצלה הופכות מן הרגע למעידת האלים? בשביל להתנתק מן החוף המר, אתם הייתם מוכנים לשים את מבטחכם בתכלילי הצלה. צעקתכם נשמרה בנו ונהפכת לשיר דק מן הדק. ליווי של צעקה אילמת. והנופלים על החופים, המגורשים מן הים, נטושי כוח. אנחנו זרים והזרות כבתה עינינו מבכי, ואם ניפול ונמות, נשים טובות אולי, תאמרנה, האיש הזה זר, נזרוק עליו קומץ אפר, שלא יאכל אותו הטעם. בית כנסת קטן, מה עשו לך? עיקו אותך מן הצדדים, באו אליך מאחור, מן הגב, בעורמה, באו אליך מן המעלה, ועכשיו אתה קיר נופל על קיר נופל, בית כנסת קטן, עכשיו אתה שני קירות נפולים, אדמה שפוחה, ליבי בך, ליבי באדמה שפוחה, בית כנסת קטן. התגדל והתקדש בבית הכנסת המיותם, אל מול ברוכי דהויה, לבדי בבית הכנסת הגדול, ועל כתפיי זיכרון היהודים שנלקחו מכאן, ואני היחד בכל בתי הכנסת, ואני היחד אל מול הזיכרון לבד עומד בבית כנסת ריק, אל מול פרוכת מיותמת וקורא, התגדל והתקדש, התגדל והתקדש, רודריגו לופז, שחיפשת רק את האמת, לסלק את כל המכאובים מהאנשים, וגמלו לך במוות מכוער, נתנו לראות במו עיניך את קרביך הנפרמים. רודריגו לופז, התגדל והתקדש אנטוניו ז'וזה דה סילבה, שאתה ידעת לשורר את שמחת החיים, את תפארת החיים. גדעו אותך ואימך מעיר לעיר, מארץ לארץ, עד מותך המקרה. התגדל והתקדש, שמתחת ליופי הזה המדומה, עורמת, עורמת שואלים וביזוי עד דקה, שאתם הפכתם יהודים לנלעגים בפרצוף של כלב עם כובע. מי יסלח לכם? מי ישכח לכם? כי העבר עדיין מבעבע, כי הקבר הוא רק מכסה, אבל הוא אינו סולח.
Trees allowing testimony to come. A deep well in the patio allowing testimony to come. Ancient olives and the hum of the sea. It is all alive. Since under this veneer, under this calm, there's another calm. A calm that is fear. The fear of knocking down locks, the fear of homes that might break open with sagging walls. Because under this calm, the earth is bubbling with Hebrew letters. Books aren't hidden under innocent trees. Because under this calm there are loud cries, muted voices. Because under this calm the time is nothing but a crumbling illusion. Verses are engraved in neglected ceilings of abandoned synagogues. Because under this calm the flesh is dissected by crushing stones and sharp iron spikes. Because under this calm Torah scrolls are fermenting hundreds of years in glass cabinets, behind locked doors and cellars. Speaking about a city to its base. Ah, for my Jews parting from a city whose streets are these slippery slopes spurring their feet to leave. Ah, for the Jews parting from a city who sealed its name on their back like a flickering sign in the world, Toledo. To the Jews of Spain and Portugal, expelled and lost at sea, how can the mute cry be gathered from the sea when lifeboats in an instant become a fading of the gods? Severing your ties from the bitter shore, you entrusted your lives in phantom rafts. Your cry lingers on within us, turning into the subtlest of poems, the accompaniment of a mute cry. To the expelled falling on remote shores, we are foreign and our eyes spent from weeping. And if we die, kind women passing by will say, this man is a foreigner, a Jew. Let us throw a little earth on him so that the jackal won't eat them. Little synagogue, you are beaten up on every side. They came at you from behind, from the back, scheming they came at you from above. And now you are a wall falling on a falling wall. Little synagogue, now you are two walls falling, shed soil. My heart is in you, my heart is in the shed soil. A little synagogue. It gadal v'it kadash, in the abandoned synagogue, facing the faded veil, alone in the great synagogue. And on my shoulders, I bear the memory of the Jews that were taken from here. And I am the one in all the synagogues, and I am the one facing the memory, standing alone in an empty synagogue, empty of its congregation, facing the orphan veil, reciting It Gadal V'It Kadash. Rodrigo Lopez, your love for the truth, your devotion to remove pain, rewarded you with an ugly death. They let you watch your own guts being spilled. Rodrigo Lopez, It Gadal V'It Kadash. Antonio Jugé de Silva, you who knew how to rhyme the poetry of life in all its glory, nipped you in the bud. From city to city, from land to land, until your sorry death. It gadal v'it kadash, because under this imagined beauty, the deception of foxes, the massive contempt, has turned Jews into ridiculed people, the face of a hooded dog.
Thank you, Erez Biton, for sharing with us your poetry that was dedicated to the expelled Jews from Spain and Portugal. And thank you, Valda, for the wonderful translation that was really in a fast, for a fast time and speedy. So it's really wonderful to work with you. And the second one is working also with the DAHAN Center that came also especially from Israel, not only as a lecturer in the conference, but as a partner who is representing the Ashkelon College Academy. And I mean Dr. Pinhas Haliwa, who is the general director of the Ashkelon College Academy, that we are going to get working together for the last 8 years. When I'm talking about working together, I'm talking about a full partnership in all meaning, including all the staff, academic staff that attends every conference and contribute to the conference, like now also that a nice delegation that came from the Ashkelon College, and we were all over the world. We were together at the Sorbonne in Paris, we were together in Macedonia, we were together in Sao Paulo in Brazil, we were in Montreal, and we were in Tbilisi in Georgia. And I believe that that's besides all the work that we are doing together in Israel, in the college, the Ashkelon College itself, with the local conventions and the seminars that we are spending. So this is all to opportunity also to recognize all the contribution of this college to the DAHAN Center and to say thank you for the partnership for so many years. So I have the pleasure to call upon Dr. Pinhas Haliwa, the General Director of the Bakasha.
Good evening, everyone. Dr. Shimon Hayon, Director of DAHAN Center, Bar-Ilan University. Mr. Gabriel Steinhardt, President of the Jewish Community. Professor Shimon Shavit, Rector of Ashkelon Academic College. Mr. Rafael Gamzu, Dr. Rafael Gamzu, Ambassador of Israel to Portugal. The poet Erez Biton. First, I would like to thank the DAHAN Center and its director, Dr. Shimon Hayon, for organizing the conference together with Lisbon and Porto universities. I would like to thank Mrs. Sora Koberkowski for organizing and taking care of everything. Ashkelon Academic College is among the very few academic colleges in Israel that compels its students to take courses in Judaism and Jewish history of both the BA and the master's programs. Although we're not teaching Judaism and Jewish history, this is the seventh year that we are participate and support conferences the DAHAN Center organizes. In the past, we held conference in Morocco with our students who studied with Professor Moshe Amar about the Jewish life there. We also support conferences in this kind in Israel, as we already held conferences about Jewish life in Morocco, Libya, Yemen, and Georgia. And I would like to present some details about Ashkelon Academic College, and I move to Hebrew. המכללה האקדמית אשקלון היא אחת מ-22 מכללות ציבוריות בישראל, שנתמכות על ידי ות"ת, המועצה להשכלה גבוהה, ואחת הגדולות שבהן אנחנו מציעים 20 חוגים לתואר שני, 3 חוגים לתואר 20 חוגים לתואר ראשון, 3 חוגים לתואר שני. אנחנו מציעים כלכלה, חשבונאות, ניהול, מדעי הבריאות, פקולטה שמתפתחת מאוד, פסיכולוגיה, מדעי המחשב, ותארים שניים בקרימינולוגיה, עבודה סוציאלית וכלכלה. סך הכל לומדים במכללה כ-6,000 סטודנטים, מתוכם 3,700 לתארים אקדמיים, והשאר מכינות, לימודי הנדסאים. יש לנו מכינות לעולים שאנחנו קולטים הישר מחוץ לארץ למכללה. לצערנו, אתם יודעים שהמועמדים היום לא נמשכים למקצועות שאין בהם פרקטיקה ויישום תעסוקה. וזאת משום שהאוניברסיטאות שנים רבות ממלאות תפקיד מקצועי ולא רק קידום המחקר והמדע. אני שימשתי בתפקיד הרבה שנים כיושב ראש פורום המכללות האקדמיות בישראל, ור"מ, מה שמקביל לור"ה, וטענו הרבה שנים שצריך ליצור הבחנה בין תפקיד האוניברסיטאות לבין תפקיד המכללות, שהכוונה שהאוניברסיטאות יהיו חוד החנית של המחקר והמדע בישראל, והמכללות תעסוקנה בלימודים אקדמיים מקצועיים יישומיים, אבל כנראה שאין מנהיגות מספיק החלטית במועצה להשכלה גבוהה ובות"ת כדי שיבצעו את המשימה הזו לטובת המדינה. ואנחנו רואים, לצערנו, כולם יודעים, כל המשלחות באוניברסיטה והמכללות יודעות, כל משלחת פה בארץ יודעת, שהחוגים למדעי היהדות ומדעי הרוח מתרוקנים. אין שם תלמידים, וזה בגלל שקצת היוצרות התבלבלו, האוניברסיטאות עוסקות להמשיך במחקר, לעסוק במחקר, וככה למשוך תלמידים למקצועות של המחקר, והמכללות יעסקו במקצועות היישומיים. אז כפי שאתם רואים, אנחנו, למרות שלא מלמדים, אנחנו תומכים, ואנחנו חושבים שזה מאוד חשוב, ואנחנו, אני חושב, המכללה היחידה שיש לה חוג אחד במדעי הרוח, בהיסטוריה, כן? לימודי ארץ ישראל. אני מקווה שיפור אחרינו בחרות אחרות. אז שוב אני רוצה לאחל, רוצה להודות, להודות לכולם, למשלחת שלנו בראשות פרופסור שרביט והרב פרופסור עמר. אני רוצה לאחל לכולנו כנס מעניין, מורה ומוצלח. ערב טוב, תודה רבה.
I'd like to invite for his message your Excellency, the Ambassador of Israel in Portugal, Mr. Rafael Gamzu.
I don't know if when we heard together the great poetry of our Israel laureate Erez Biton, me in Hebrew and you in the very good English translation, you had some of the same thoughts that crossed my mind. And I will share with you a day of the life of an Israeli ambassador to Portugal. Last Friday, I was honored to be guest together with Secretary of State, Mendes Godinho, a guest of the lovely mayor of a great, small, but a real jewel, town in the upper Alentejo, Castelo de Vigo. And we spent the day together with Secretary of State and other lovely people. And we did, we had a very interesting and moving agenda of visit. We started the day by fixing a mezuzah on a new agriturismo or rural tourism project in the outskirts of Castelo de Vigo, a facility, a premises that will let Jewish tourists who wish to visit the area with rich Jewish history, people who care about keeping and observing kosher, and we'll have the first opportunity, the first time we'll have the opportunity to have a beautiful facility of tourism with bon gusto, really very refined and lovely place. Initiative by a couple of American Jews who spent their time, divided their time between New York, Cascais, and Mozambique, who fell in love with Portugal, how cannot they, and decided to have, among other initiatives, to have this one. So this was the beginning of our morning, setting a new mezuzah on this new facility. And then Erez, together with Minister Godinho and others, we went to the Judaria of Castelo de Vigo. And we visited a synagogue that corresponds so perfectly with the synagogue that you mentioned in your great poetry. An abandoned synagogue. A synagogue that is there as a monument to the Jewish past. And I, an Israeli sabra, not the best Jew when it comes to practicing Judaism or religion, I was extremely moved to see the space of the old mezuzah still there, empty. But serving after the renovation taken care by these beautiful people of Castelo Levin, the renovation of this synagogue, turning it into a monument, but also a live, modest, but still important educational center to tell the story of the Jews of their town and the Jews of Portugal in general. It was definitely a moving moment, and I think it was a moving one for Secretary of State Godinho as well. And therefore, you historians, distinguished guests from Israel, Portuguese, others, you are digging in the history, which is so important, because if we don't know our history, including the shadows and the bleak points of our joint history, we will always have difficulties to face our present and, not less important, our future. And we diplomats and politicians, we have to be inspired by your research, to study it, and to turn it into shaping our joint and common life, and hopefully turn it into a better future for the generations to come. Thank you very much. I'm very glad to be together with President Steinhardt and with the community. The Israeli embassy is more than glad to host you tonight in this beautiful and so important synagogue. And President Steinhardt, I believe that when there is the next international conference, the mayor and the government will help you to have a bigger space to host all of Dr. Ohayon's guests. And even if they expand in numbers during the days, we will be able together, or the future ambassador, to host them in a generous way as you are doing it here tonight. Thank you all. And I hope we have more successful conferences of this kind in the future. Thank you very much.
To conclude the protocol part of this ceremony, we are pleased to invite Your Excellency, the Secretary of State for Tourism of Portugal, and Amadeus Godinho.
Dear Ambassador Rafael Gamzu, dear Gabriel Steinhardt, dear Rabbi Nathan Perez, I'm sorry to choose this person because I've been working with you so much in the recent past, and you've been such good friends for me. Thank you so much. You've been unique partners in promoting our Jewish heritage in Portugal, and this has been our mission in common. First of all, I would like to tell you how much honored I am to be here with you. You can't imagine how intense it has been to share with you and with this group some moments in promoting the Jewish heritage in all over the world. We've been in the US doing some sessions promoting the Jewish heritage in Portugal, and it has been so touching to see how people are curious and want to learn more about this presence. And what's more interesting is how curious the Portuguese people are to find out this common history. You can't imagine what I've grown myself, what I've grown in the last months in terms of learning about how the Portuguese history and how the Portuguese culture is so connected to the Jewish history. It's amazing to find out this in our every session that we do, that we are always learning new things about these connected worlds that we share. I would like to thank you so much for choosing Portugal for this conference. For us, it's very important also to be a stage for this discussion, this discovery, this knowledge. We need knowledge to understand the past, to understand the present, and to guarantee that we promote the best future for all of us. I would like to strengthen that the history of Portugal is completely connected to the history of the Jewish communities in Portugal. We cannot forget that if Portugal discovered the world by sea 500 years ago, this was because we had very important Jewish people that influenced and even drove the boats, like Pedro Álvares Cabral. So our history is completely influenced by the presence of the Jewish communities in Portugal. We had very important physicians, we had very important astronomers that even built the maps that drove us to find other worlds and to conquer, discover other continents. We can never forget, as Gabriel just told us before, that 20% of the Portuguese population in the 14th century was Jew. And this means that every Portuguese is always trying to find someone in the family that must be a Jew. When we went in the US, people even approached me asking, well, Mendes, maybe you have some Jewish origin. This is to say that the Jewish culture is part of our DNA. It's just very interesting that we need to know more about this. We need to spread the word, and we need to understand why sometimes we have so many things in common that we didn't know why. And history explains this and helps us understand. I would also want to say that we need to admit the past. And we had good moments and we had very dark moments in Portugal. And the darkest times of Portugal were the times of the Inquisition. For everything, they were dark, but they were also dark in terms of the development of the country. We stopped in time during the Inquisition, and we must regret for this. And this is why it was so touching, I would say for me, I think Ambassador, for you too, in Castelo David, when we heard the Mário Soares in his speech in 1989, asking for forgiveness for our past. We cannot hide our past. We have to understand the past to avoid that it will happen in the future, and even to use it as an example for other countries and other situations that are happening in the world, and we cannot allow them to happen. We have to show people that those are the darkest times of civilization. You can't even imagine how much I have discovered, as I told you, about my history, Portugal history, during this last year. How much I was touched, for example, when I heard Ladino, and I thought I was listening to Portuguese. How much I was touched when I visited the synagogue, the Portuguese-Spanish Sephardic synagogue, and in New York, and I saw so many Portuguese names. They were all over the place, the Portuguese names. So Portugal was there. So where's the difference? There's no difference. And you can't imagine how touched I was when I saw the key of Sarah Cohen, a Jewish woman, lady from Israel, that left the key, the original key of her house in Castelo David, just before she died. She left it, the key, in Castelo David. This is what should make us think, should make us learn, should make us take steps into guarantee that the darkest times of history will not repeat, and that we are active messengers of peace. Portugal, I would say, is now being discovered by the world. And it's being discovered by the world for, I would say, two things. First, for its history and culture. Second, for its people. And Portuguese people are made of the world. We are a joint, I would say, we are a melting pot of people that connected from different countries. And that's why we are positioning more and more Portugal as this meeting point between worlds, between cultures, and also a place of peace. Concluding, I would say that let us make this place where we are, this gate of hope, a message to the world, and to show the world that when we respect others, we transform the world into a much better world, and it is possible. The message that Portugal is showing the world right now, it's that in the what seemed to be impossible, it's completely possible, as long as we want, as long as we believe, as long as we follow our heart, and also our history and our souls. I even heard in the poem the name Alma, and this is, for me, it has always been part of my vocabulary. So let us believe in our Alma, let us follow our hearts, let us make this gate of hope a message to the world. Let's show the world that peace is just in the reach of our hands if we want, and we will not allow things to happen that just turn the world into a very dark place. Shalom.
But before finishing off this beautiful and emotional ceremony, I'd like to call upon
two of them already here,
Dr. Godinho, our ambassador, Dr. Pinhas also, and Dr. Schumann to join us.
And Maurice Leandro.
She was, I would like to, I think it's, you deserve a big clap of hands, you know, for everything. Director of the Jewish Community of Lisbon, would like to honor our guest speakers with a souvenir from our Bet Knesset. Well, my Hebrew is not so good. My Bet Knesset, Shaaré, Tikvá. So for that matter, we have a little souvenir for all of you. Much, and now let's have some music before dinner. Thanks so much.
I'm sorry, I just wanted to add something because I just have the numbers of the latest numbers about the number of Sephardic Jews that have already Portuguese citizenship, which is 3,210 in 2 years. So this means thank you so much for trusting in our country. Welcome.
Okay, the program now follows with another special music moment presented by the Ensemble Al'Fado, which will close this ceremony. The following will be held already out of the synagogue, a special toast, Sinagoga,
followed by dinner, which is served in the front and back of the synagogue. So we ask everyone, please, to be dispersed for your comfort. Thank you very much.
And that's it. Let's do some more music.
Pescaria mis dolores con palabras de amor. Pescaria mis dolores con palabras de amor. Thank you.
want to give you one special flavor of our own version of something that also originates from Portugal, very traditional, and another thing that we do, and that I always feel has a connection between the Hebrew Jewish people and the Portuguese people. It's one very, very important classic from Pinhas.
Agora, por ser de mim. Mm-hmm.